Next week, and you notice sheets, they're listed. Also, Ballyclough still has the last night of the midweek Advent service, which you can come to this Wednesday night if you wish to come along. So you're most welcome to join us at that. I'd just like to say, St. Columbus, this place is really lovely decorated today, this evening. I thought it looked impressive this morning, but now tonight with the darkness, it looks especially well. And I think your Christmas tree, you ever put that Christmas tree up and decorated it, did a fabulous job, okay? Who?
The guides.
Congratulations to the guides. Big shout out to the guides. St. Patrick's have a massive tree now, but I don't think it's as well as decorated as that. But don't tell them I said that, otherwise I get in deep water. But it looks fantastic. Well done to all who were involved and to the guides. Please pass that on. So we have a formal bidding prayer, which I will begin now. Let's pray. Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmas Eve our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, and heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, and with magi adore the child lying in his mother's arms. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God, from the first days of our disobedience and unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this church dedicated to one of his saints, glad with our carols of praise. But first let us pray for the needs of his whole world, for peace and for goodwill over all the earth, for unity and for brotherhood within the church he came to build, within the dominions of our sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth. And let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold and the hungry, the oppressed. Help us remember at this time the sick in body and in mind, and also them who mourn. We remember the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all who know not the loving kindness of God. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven, the words which Christ himself hath taught us. We say together, Our Father. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. grace give us the joys of everlasting life. And unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all. Amen. Amen. Folks, you'll be familiar with the routine. There will be no introductions required for any of the hymns or any of the Bible readings. They will just take natural progression as is outlined.
And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid,
because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldst not eat? And the man said, The woman who that thou givest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel.
Oh, Thank you. that Christ will bring is foreshown. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. And he shall not judge after the sight of his eyes, neither reprove after the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips shall he slay the wicked. And righteousness shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the sucking child shall play on the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea.
Yeah. Blessed Virgin Mary. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her.
Thank you. pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was, that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
The Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, and was told unto them.
Thank you. demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And though Bethlehem in the land of Judah art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.
Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired from diligently of what time the star appeared. And he sent him to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, but when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king, they departed, and lo, when the star came, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were coming to the house, they saw a young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. for their glorious, gorgeous singing. I think the anthems especially were really due. I just wanted to give them a round of applause afterwards. Thank you very much. A few calling prayers and then a final blessing. And folks, afterwards there's tea and coffee and mince pies available afterwards. Please stick around for a chat, a bit of fellowship. Please enjoy that at the end. The Christmas Call Night. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armour of light. Now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son Jesus Christ came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. And a final blessing. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, the Prince of Peace, the Wonderful Counselor, the Light of the World, may he enfold you with his love, may he fill you with peace, and lead you in hope to the end of your days. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.